King and English King, he was having trouble with Vikings. They were coming over here. They're beating the crap out of us. There's nothing we could do about it. This English King, he calls to his magician. He says, "Oi, Magi, over here." The magician trundles up to the king like this and said,
"Listen, noble magnate, what can I do for you today?"
King looks at the magician, magician looks at the king. "Well, what we need, mate, is dragons. Two little dragons, one boy, one girl, pop in a box, little boy on the top. Send them off to King What's-His-Name over there in Viking land. He'll love them. Never trouble our shores again." "You can do that, can't you? It's easy, isn't it? You're a magician, aren't you?" Magician looks at the king, king looks at the magician.
"Dragons, I am, very good, yeah. Yeah, superlative ideas, I am, very good, yeah.
Can't do dragons." King looks at the magician, magician looks at the king. The king says, "Look, mate, you got 1 week or else." "Know what I mean? No, I'm not going to cut your beard off. Grew back too fast last time. This time, mate, you're four letter worded." Magician runs off to his little subterranean cave down by the side of the sea, knees knocking together. Knows he's completely rubbish at doing magic, but very good at being a mad scientist. And he sets to work crossing all the abominable creatures upon the planet. And after 1 week of incredibly hard toil and labour, what he manages to do, ladies and gents, is cross a seagull, ladies and gents, with a lobster. Seagull lobster beastie things are now the most abominable things on the planet, and they pop in a box, two of them. Little boy on the top, send them off to King What's-His-Name over there in Viking land. He does love them. 1 week later, they breed like rabbits. They're overrun by them, overflown by them. They can't do anything about it. They have to shove them all onto this whacking great big ship and set rudder into the North Sea,
do the zigzaggy thing, into the sunset,
in search of an island on which to dump all these horrible beasts. And they find the island. And they dump us, the beasts. And just as they're about to sail off, they see this man and his missus legging it through the undergrowth, trying not to be detected. They've been on the island for decades, ladies and gents. They are madly in love. And the Vikings do the unspeakable. They nick the guy's missus, sail off into the sunset, and they don't even bother doing this attacky thing. They leave our mate on the side of the cliff, singing to his love who he's never going to see again, played by all these horrible lobster, seagull, chimeric, beastie things that are flying around his head. Anyway, our mate, he's good with a bow and arrow, knocks one out of the air, I'll tell you for why. Pops it on his head. See, our mate, he's a bit of a Nostradamus type. And he's seen into the future, and he's seen two things, ladies and gents. Number one, he's seen Barry White. Barry White singing low and smoochy. The other thing he's seen in the future, ladies and gents, here, Shrek 1. The bit from Shrek 1 where little Bluebird is flying up in front of the princess, and princess hits the eye door and notes, and little Bluebird goes. And so, having seen both these things from the future, I pop this beast upon his head, he launches into this plan to sing low and smoochy like Barry White. And when all these beasts are all close and all loved up and all cuddly, he hits the high notes and he pops up. And this, ladies and gents, is a bit where I need a little bit of audience participation from your good selves. So when you hear this, seagulls, no!
Seagulls, no!
When you hear that, ladies and gents, I would like you to do your best seagull impressions.
Seagulls, no!
Now do not worry if you cannot do a seagull. If you cannot do a seagull, do a five-yard animal with wings. Pick a cow, a donkey, a horse, a pig, put wings on it. Make the noise. If you can't do that, do a fire engine. Do anything, just make a racket. Are you ready? Yes! One, two, three!
Teagles, no! Teagles, no! Teagles, no! Teagles, no!
Sat in a field. Nobody's gonna recognize this song, ladies and gents. Not even the brothers who wrote it. Barry White, everybody.
Barry White, everybody.
Two, three, four.
Oh, my speckled dove. My lobster seagull beats.
Time goes by so slowly, and time can do so much. Are you still mad? Yeah, I need your love.
Give it some, yes.
I need your love. God, speed your love to me.
Get ready with your seagulls. It's in now. Yes, now. Eat down, bounty, yes. Bounty, yes. I can't hear the seagulls. More seagulls. Eat down, bounty, yes. Bounty, yes. Have cone and mess. Bounty, yes. Have cone and bounty. Keep it going, folks, yes. Bounty, yes. Have cone.
Or in English now, lonely mountains gaze at the stars, waiting for the dawn of the day. You'll get another chance in a bit. Oh, Lord, I gaze at the stars, waiting for my love. Of hunger for your touch. Yeah! A long, lonely time. And need your love.
Get ready.
I need your love.
Tinkles now!
Go on! Speed your love!
Sat in the field, give yourself a massive round of applause for being the best seagulls on the planet!
Hey gents, I've come to the part in my set where I'm gonna worth it. I'm gonna do something traditional. I'm gonna do a lovely folk song by a guy called Richard Thompson. Beautiful lyrics. Where's my, I need me sensible hat. Where's me sensible hat? No sensible hat!
Sensible hat.
It's my sensible hat. Oh, where's that bit? I can see the way you're holding it. I'll do your swap after. Too twangy. Yeah. Ladies and gents, Richard Thompson song, Bee's Wing. I was 18 when I came to town, they called it the summer of love. They were burning babies, burning flags of hawks against the dust. I took a job on a steaming way, down by the Cartram Street. Fell in love with a laundry girl who was working next to me. A look of half surprise, like a fox caught in the headlights. There was animal in her eyes. She said, "Oh, young man, can't you see I'm not the factory kind? If you don't take me out of here, I'll surely lose my mind." She was a red, fine as a bee's wing, so fine a breath of wind might blow her away. She was a last chance. She was born and wild. She said, "As long as there's no price on love, I'll stay. Wouldn't have me any other way." Working down the market towns, picking fruit in Kent. We could tinker pots and pans and knives wherever we went. While we were camping down the car one time, the pay was mighty good. She thought we shouldn't stay for the frost, but me, I thought we should. That said, oh lady, let's settle down. Let's get some acres dough. Fire burning in the heart, babies on the road. She said, oh man, you foolish man, but Charlie sounds like hell. You might be lord of half the world, you not own me as well. She was a red, fine as a bee's wing. As fine a breath of wind might blow away. She was a lost, she was put on wild. She said, as long as there's no price on love, I'll stay. You wouldn't have me any other way. There's no price on love, I say. We were drinking more those days, our tempers reached a pitch. Like a fool, I let her run, she took the rambling itch. Oh, at last I heard she was living rough, down on a Derby beat. Bottle of white horse in her pocket, a wolf found at her feet. Oh, that's how I heard it, she got married once to a man named Romany Brown. Even a gypsy caravan was too much like settling down. Oh, no price. There's no price. No price on love, I say. Oh, they say her rose is faded. Rough weather and hard boots. I guess that that's the price you pay for the chains that you refuse. She was a red, fine as a bee's wing. So fine I might have crushed her where she lay. If I could just feel her of her wildness now and hold her in my arms today. I wouldn't have her any other way. How long have we got left, Oz? 5 minutes, 3 minutes, 3 minutes.
5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10, 5, 10,
musical or a bit of both? Can I do a musical one and then a bonkers one? Yeah? Let's do it! Ladies and gents, this is a Cat Stevens number. Beautiful song called The Wind. And for anyone who wasn't here right at the beginning, what I got down at my feet is called a loop machine. It's a sound catcher. And this is the way it works. Kick a button like this, starts recording. Kick a button like this, starts recording.
Kick a button like this, starts recording. Kick a button like this, starts recording.
Kick a button like this, starts recording. Kick a button like this, starts recording. If you get a kick in the wrong place, you've had it. Big piece of mischief, this machine. Big piece of mischief. Would have been burnt at the stake 200 years ago for having one of these. Ladies and gents, I'm going to do this lovely piece by Cat Stevens, and then I'm going to do a bit of performance poetry that's going to have you hopefully jumping up and down, bouncing on the spot. Thank you.
listen to the wind of my soul. Where I end up, I think only God really knows. I'm gonna bring the levels down.
Oh, my God.
got time to bounce. I've only got one working leg, but I'm an Olympian. Ladies and gents, you're all Vikings. Let me hear you make a noise like a Viking now. You're all in your villages making babies and eating food. When down from the sky there comes the most horrible blue, green, yellow, polka-dotted paisley dragon you've ever seen in your lives. Yeah. Lands in your fields. With a swish of his tail, completely flattens all the clots and teepees in your village. With snorting fire from his nostrils, he incinerates all your woods and your forests. It hasn't bad enough, he swallows the moon and the sun. What are you gonna do? Run! Run to the hills! Yes! Ladies and gents, this is a story of an ingenious plan that was found by a Viking village to conquer their horrible dragon. Are you ready for this? Yeah! If you want to bounce, bounce. If you sat down on your seats, you can bounce on your seats. Hey! Hey! It was when the dragon first came, with a flapping of wings and a crackle of flames. Our houses were burnt, our crops are all ash, raised to the ground in an almighty flash. But our seasons, they have changed, our seasons, they have changed, and we are weak and cold. So we call to our allies from far across the sea, the brave and the strong and the fierce and the free. But this was the answer that came back to me! Who are you? Who are you? What's your name? You're dead for me, your grandmother! Make something, my grandmother! She never done me nothing for this thing! She never... Not funny! You're what? You want I come cross your river? You want I punch your dragon? Dragon! You think I'm stupid? I'm not stupid. I never hit dragon. Never. I'm not stupid. I never hit. The darkness came and he swallowed the moon, and all hell fell upon us from dusk until noon. For we hoped for the sun, but he swallowed that too.
Oh. The bastard!
And our seasons, they have changed. Our seasons are all deranged. We only have light from our flames, and we are weak and cold. So we call to our wise men, oh yes, said, what shall we do? And they gave us ideas, oh yes, they had quite a few, but most were just crap, and the rest were all blue, because they just couldn't get enough. No, they just couldn't get any muff. Such serious, studious fools, no lass wanted to shag 'em or bear 'em a brood. For the seasons never change, the seasons never change for those who cannot laugh. Then came a young woman, yes, Job was her name, with a big spotty bottom and a wonderful brain. She said, hey boys, I know who to blame. Let's get down to the city now, boys. Down to the city now. And down in the city, in the sewers of wealth, we found all those bastards who knacker your health. Bailiffs. Bank managers. Tele licensing too. And all the other bastards who live in that zoo. And we gathered them all together. Yes, we knew that was what we should do. We gathered them up into 10-gallon vats and we rolled them up where the fat dragon sat, and he gobbled them up and then he spat. Go forth and bring me more. That's scary, that bit, eh? Oh, yeah. So we brought him plenty more, and we rolled him to his door. And now, folks, it's party time, isn't it? You know what it's like when the band manager puts a letter to your letterbox and says, "You, sir, you went 2p over because you bought a finger of fudge for your mate, and now we're going to charge you 40 quid. And at the end of the month, it's going to be 30, 40, 180. And if you don't like it, it's tough, isn't it? You can't bring a tank to our bank, put the tank through the wall of the bank, because we'll get the police on the tank, and put the tank, end of story, in it. Yes. And the dragon, the mighty dragon, has swallowed 500 vats of bank managers, bailiffs. He's a goner, isn't he? Hey, party time! Bouncing on the seats! Bouncing on the seats! Bouncing on the seats! Piggyback bouncing! Give these people a round of applause for piggyback bouncing, yes! For 20 long years he lay flat on his back, clutching his belly, as sick as a rat. But it hurt even more when the poor dragon shat!
Oh my God!
Cost the bastards burnt his ring! You should have heard him sing with a wail like a banshee. He coughed up the sun, and then with the mightiest blast from his bum, the moon it followed soon. Oh, the moon it followed soon. Oh. And now, with our day and our night fresh restored, we are ready to reap all our worthy rewards. Our crops grow strong in the ash of his waste, and we throw dragon shite in our enemy's face. Yeah! Ladies and gents, my name is Ash Mandrake. Oh, you're gonna laugh with me this evening. I sat in a field. You are the best seagulls on the planet. It has to be said. Yes. Take care, folks. Have a lovely festival. I do have some CDs for sale. I've got 3 live CDs. 3 quid each, or all 3 for a fiver. 2 studio CDs, a fiver each. Or you can buy all 5 for a tenner.
Buy all 5 for a fucking tenner. Get in there. Woo-hoo!
You can hit that back.
What did you think of Ash? Like a box of frogs, we love this guy. Give it one more blast for Ash Mandrake, please.
Boring. Damn it. Ah, bullshit.